From the rarest primate in the world to the most trafficked animal ever, and the possible cause of the coronavirus, here are the 10 rarest animals that are hardly seen. Number 10. Shoebill stork. The shoebill stork is undoubtedly the rarest and strangest of all the birds. For one thing, it's huge. It's probably taller than your mailbox, boasting an impressive 8-foot wingspan and standing over 4.5 feet tall. This enormous prehistoric bird has a massive bill it uses for eating fish. In fact, the shoebill stork is also known as the whale-headed stork because of its bizarre size. But they are not actually storks. They have their own classification because they are so unique. They use their bills for eating, of course, but also to make all kinds of loud clacking noises. This almost could have been a pelican, but at some point in its evolution it took a different path. Surprisingly, the shoebill stork can live to be around 35 years old. Seems quite a long time for such a big bird, right? But you are very unlikely to ever see one in the wild. The bird is classified as vulnerable by the International Union for Conservation of Nature. According to them, there are only 3,000 to 5,000 shoebills left in their native wetlands of Central and East Africa. The population is in a steep decline due to habitat loss and disturbance by humans, not to mention the illegal bird trade. What do you think of this giant bird? Is it cool? Ugly? Intimidating? Let me know in the comments below. Number 9. Amur leopard. Most people think leopards live specifically in Africa, but this is not true. The Amur leopard makes its home in the east of Russia. It has adapted to living in the temperate forests and now thrives in the cold regions of the Far East. Just like other leopards, this one can run at astounding speeds, reaching up to 37 miles per hour. It has also been reported to leap up to 10 feet vertically and up to 19 feet horizontally, making it one of the best jumpers in the world. Unlike other animals, the male Amur leopards have been known to stay with their female mates even after breeding. Some even help with raising the young cubs. In the wild, these leopards can live anywhere between 10 and 15 years, but in captivity they can live over 20 years. Other names for the Amur leopard include the Far East leopard, the Korean leopard, and the Manchurian leopard. Unfortunately, this is another rare animal that is hardly seen anywhere on Earth. The World Wildlife Foundation has marked them as critically endangered, with a measly population of just around 80. This spectacular leopard could be erased off the face of the Earth sooner rather than later. Number 8. Hainan black-crested gibbon. It's difficult to see monkeys in the forest. It's even more difficult to spot primates in the wild. But if you want an even greater challenge, just try and find a Hainan black-crested gibbon. This is the world's rarest primate, only weeks, months, or even a year away from being extinct. Out of all of the 504 primate species, this one is the rarest and most vulnerable. You can only find this gibbon at the southern tip of China, living on a tropical island confined to a tiny patch of forest. In this little area they call home, there are about 25 gibbons left. That is not a lot. In fact, even the other 19 recognized species of gibbons, which live scattered throughout Southeast Asia, are either endangered or critically endangered, with the exception of only one. Not only is the Hainan black-crested gibbon at the edge of oblivion as the rarest primate, but it's also one of the rarest mammals of all time. You remember that tiny patch of forest they live in? Well, it's less than 2 square miles. Imagine if there were only 25 people left on Earth and they all lived in the same apartment complex. That's exactly what this is like. Unless you manage to book a trip to this island, you will never behold one of these incredible primates with your own two eyes. Number 7. Black-eyed leaf frog. Primates and big cats are not the only animals that are elusive and extremely rare. The black-eyed leaf frog is a tiny amphibian that you are very unlikely to run into at any point in time. However, its situation is not as dire as it used to be. This little frog lives in Latin America, from Mexico all the way through Central America. And while it was on the red list of critically endangered species just 10 years ago, it has since been removed from any such list. It's now not anywhere close to being extinct. According to the International Union for Conservation of Nature, researchers have found this leaf frog thriving in a bunch of new locations and multiplying in extremely high numbers. It seems that this little frog is rebounding back from the brink of no return, and you can now find them hanging out in lots of different areas of the jungle, primarily in Guatemala. Still, that doesn't mean you're going to see one of these elusive frogs on your next jungle outing. They are so small and so green that it's unlikely you would see one if it were right in front of you sitting on a leaf. What separates these frogs from others is their huge black eyes that look like pure black marbles. Number 6. Greater bamboo lemur. The greater bamboo lemur is the biggest of all the bamboo lemurs. It was first discovered in 1870 and was believed to have gone extinct even before the beginning of the 20th century. However, the greater bamboo lemur was discovered a second time in 1972. It came back from the void of no return. This is one of the only mammals in the world that primarily eats bamboo. The lemur is totally dependent on its bamboo food source, and so it lives a pretty lazy life, spending almost all of its time nibbling away in the forest. The biggest problem is that as such a specialized animal, the greater bamboo lemur can't just change its habitat. It's an extremely basic animal that has evolved over 60 million years to live on the island of Madagascar eating nothing but bamboo. As you can imagine, as the forests of Madagascar are quickly cleared, as illegal logging and mining cuts down the bamboo and burns down the forest, the greater bamboo lemur is forced deeper and deeper into seclusion. This is not a very populous animal. You definitely won't find it roaming freely from branch to branch, but they're not gone yet. Number 5. Pika. One look at the pika, and you know without a doubt it was the inspiration for the famous Pokemon mascot Pikachu. Give this little mammal a yellow paint job and I guarantee it could shoot lightning out of its butt. But there is no other creature quite like it. The pika lives in the mountains of Western North America and all throughout Asia. And even though they look like rats or mice, pikas are not rodents. They are the smallest types of lagomorphs. The only other animals inside the lagomorph family are hares and rabbits. That means the pika is the smallest and strangest rabbit on Earth. It kind of looks like a furry egg. And guess what? There are 29 different species of pika. They have long fur, they are super soft, and they also have very furry feet. But unlike rabbits and hares, they don't have long forelimbs for jumping. The reason you will never see a pika is because they are so tiny. A typical pika only weighs about 7 ounces and is only about 6 inches in length. They also live very secluded lives, making their nests inside the nooks and crannies of rock piles. They construct burrows and spend most of their time hanging out in deep underground labyrinths. Number 4. Darwin's fox. Darwin's finches are probably his most famous animal. However, there was another creature that helped Charles Darwin develop his incredible theory of evolution, and it's now referred to as Darwin's fox. The story comes from December in 1832. Charles Darwin was only 1 year into his famous research expedition aboard the HMS Beagle. He was in the middle of scrambling up an embankment on the coast of a small Chilean island when he discovered a little grey fox watching him. The fox was much different than their relatives on the mainland of Chile. This one was also the first that he had ever seen. Darwin caught the animal, created a scientific record of it, and decided it was a new species in 1837. Its proper name is Lycalopex fulvipes, but it is better known as Darwin's fox. Fast forward 200 years and we still hardly know anything about this fox. It is extremely rare. Recent scientific discoveries revealed that Darwin's fox also inhabits a few forested regions on the mainland of Chile. However, the International Union for Conservation of Nature has classified the species as endangered, claiming that there are fewer than 1,000 of them left in the world. What makes their story of potential extinction slightly different than the usual is that their main threat comes from dogs. Domestic dogs often hunt and kill the smaller foxes, and so they are having a difficult time keeping their numbers up, which is a real shame, as this is one of the most adorable and most unique foxes you will never see. Number 3. Peruvian black spider monkey. The Peruvian black spider monkey makes its home in the Amazon forests of Brazil, Bolivia, and Peru. And while many monkeys are having a difficult time with the destruction of their habitats, the Peruvian spider monkey is having a worse time than the rest. It's been endangered since 2014 and is heavily trafficked as an illegal pet. This is hardly surprising considering how unique and adorable, or ugly, depending on who you are, the monkey is. They typically live in groups of about 35 monkeys, but it's almost impossible to find a gathering that large in the jungle anymore, seeing as there are not many of them left. What we do know is that the Peruvian black spider monkey enjoys eating fresh fruit, and so the best time to try and spot one is in the fruiting season in the Amazon basin, particularly on the Peruvian side. Number 2. Black-footed ferret. Ferrets are cool. There's no getting around it. We all knew somebody as a teenager who had some ferrets running around their house instead of cats. These animals are slippery, super fast, and they absolutely stink when you have one in your home. And while the ferrets you typically see in weird people's houses are plentiful, the black-footed ferret is actually endangered. According to the WWF, there are only around 370 of this type of ferret left in the world. In fact, they were once believed to be completely extinct, but the black-footed ferret is now making a comeback. Throughout the last 30 years, efforts from state and federal agencies, Native American tribes, conservation organizations, and zoos have given the black-footed ferret another chance to survive. Recovery efforts have helped boost their population to what it is today, still less than 400, but a lot better than zero. For this reason alone, I highly recommend helping this ferret to recover. If you have the chance, adopt a dozen of them and breed 100 of them. Number 1. Pangolin. I don't care what anyone says, there is nothing on this planet more adorable than a baby pangolin. And yeah, even adult pangolins are pretty cute. However, just like the rest of the animals on this list, they are plummeting into extinction. Pangolins are actually mammals with scales that in theory are supposed to protect them. Like anteaters, they eat ants and termites with their long sticky tongue, which can even be longer than the animal's body. They also hold the title as the most trafficked animal in the world and are treasured among illegal wildlife traders for their scales. What makes this absolutely infuriating is that pangolin scales are pulverized for use in mythical medicines that hold absolutely no value anywhere in the scientific world. Basically, poachers steal the pangolins so they can turn their scales into witch medicine for crazy people. Sorry to say it, but it's true. We need to stick up for these animals. The World Wildlife Fund says that based on reported seizures between 2011 and 2013, an estimated 116,000 to 234,000 pangolins were killed. Seizures represent as little as 10% of the actual volume of pangolins in illegal wildlife trade. But the bizarre story here is how the pangolin is related to the coronavirus outbreak. A lot of people have been talking about bat soup, but the truth is that the coronavirus outbreak could have been transmitted from bats to humans via pangolins. This isn't verified science, and the study isn't even published, but some scientists, according to Fauna and Flora International, the world's oldest conservation charity, are claiming that the pangolin is the most likely intermediate host of the coronavirus. As of now, this is still not proven, it's just a theory. The good news is that in June of this year, China increased protection for the native Chinese pangolin, Manis pentadactyla, to the highest level, so the species can no longer be eaten even in the country itself, and the government will no longer allow the use of pangolin scales in traditional medicine. It's probably because they could be a threat to global health and carry diseases that can possibly be transmitted to humans too. Hopefully it's not too late. What do you think about these ultra-rare animals? Have you ever seen one in real life or at the zoo or while traveling? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. See you again soon for another amazing video.